All right, page 22. Mary, God's mother. Funny how just a Amish book, you know, very popular among the Amish, would have Mary, this veneration of Mary. And you'll see it gets a lot worse. And, you know, let me just say this, too, before we continue. A lot of these remedies and cures and things are just ridiculous. They're so far out there, they're nutty. You know, sure, absolutely understand that. But you're going to see this thing of horrible cruelty to animals, outright murder, dealing with dead corpses and stuff like this. There's definitely that black magic satanic side to this whole thing. It's really disgusting. Here you have page 23. Nor eat pork for 9 days, commanding to abstain from meats. You see it? The Bible condemns that. To attach a dog to a person, provided nothing else was used before to effect it, try to draw some of your blood and let the dog eat it along with his food, and he will stay with you. Prohibitions against eating blood and drinking blood, and you certainly don't give it to your dog to eat. A precaution against injuries. Whoever carries the right eye of a wolf fastened inside of his right sleeve remains free from all injuries. Okay, yeah. Archangel Gabriel, I conjure thee in the name of God the Almighty to tell me, is there any water here or not? Do tell me. Water witching is what this is called. Okay, and then you see the three crosses there. Again, just as a Roman Catholic does. You know, you see they do these prayers and they like this and stuff. They're crossing themselves. And it's funny because that's actually, the cross is a curse. You know, Jesus became sin who knew no sin. You know, the Bible talks about, let me get the verse here real quickly. But it's just so many weird things with this whole system. And, you know, all you got to do is just read the Bible and clear it right up. Galatians chapter 3, verse 13. Christ hath redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is every one that hangeth on a tree. He was a curse there. That cross was not a Christian cross. It's a pagan symbol, basically commemorating Tammuz. That's why it's a T. All right? And you get sacrifice. It's ritual, you know, sacrifice there. They call it human sacrifice. I don't genuinely use the term human, but you know, because it's not a Bible word, and if you get in, again, you get into that study, Hugh was a Druid god, so if you're a Hugh man, that's kind of like a man of Hugh, the Druid god, but that's another story. But it's a ritual sacrifice thing. Jesus wasn't killed by Christians, he was killed by pagan Romans, right? That's why they put him on that cross, right? And he was made a curse there. So when you're doing this thing all the time, you're doing that. I'm just showing it, you know, like the Catholics do. They do like this, and then they do this. You know, they'll even touch themselves like that. They're cursing themselves over and over and over again. Yeah. Page 24. A sure way of catching fish. Take rose seed and mustard seed in the foot of a weasel and hang these in a net, and the fish will certainly collect there. We're just going to go catch a weasel and cut its foot off, I guess. It's disgusting. Sanctus Autorius Res. Nice little Latin thing there. Call the rest. Hear the mother of God come to his came to his assistance. All right? Calling the mother of God for assistance, huh? A good remedy for bad wounds and burns. The word of God, the milk of Jesus' mother. That's nice. And Christ's blood is for all wounds and burnings good. Cross yourself three times. It is the safest way in all these cases to make the crosses with the hand or thumb three times over the affected parts, which that is to say over all those things to which the three crosses are attached. Okay? Plainer words, what you do is you say there's wicked things there and rely on Jesus' blood and Mary's milk. Yeah. And then you cross yourself wherever the affected thing is or whatever else. Yeah. Page 26. A good remedy to stop bleeding. This is the day on which the injury happened. Blood thou must stop until the Virgin Mary bring forth another son. Okay? So I think what they're saying actually in this little curse thingy here is they're saying that the blood has to stop until the Virgin Mary bring forth another son. In other words, this isn't going to happen here. You know, interesting, because they're teaching the perpetual virginity of Mary. Oh, it wasn't, you know, Long Lost Friend wasn't written by Catholics. It was a John, you know, George Homan. It was you know, this German guy. He wrote it. No, it was written by a Catholic. Okay. Albertus Magnus was the author of this book. And they just covered up and say, oh, it's John George Homan, you know, because they don't want occult books on witchcraft and sacrifice, ritual sacrifice, to trace back to Catholicism, and not just some wingnut Catholic that some Catholics deny, were a doctor of the church, one of only 36, a canonized saint, writing books on sacrifice, where you have to use parts of corpses. We're going to see later on a skull from somebody that died. Okay, not joking. And also animals, many of which are killed while they're alive. We're dealing with sick people. Page 28. Write reversedly or backwards upon a piece of paper. It is all over. Again, this is what Alius Dracali was doing. I bet you he got it from this. To stop bleeding, count backwards. Aleister Crowley. Here we have page 29. No more than Virgin Mary shall bring forth another son. Cross yourself. A remarkable passage from the book of Albertus Magnus. See, he refers to him. It says, if you burn a large frog to ashes and mix the ashes with water, you will obtain an ointment that will, if put on any place covered with hair, destroy the hair and prevent it from growing again. All you got to do is just find a frog and burn it to death. Page 31, together with the tooth of a wolf. You get their eyeball, you get their tooth, you do all this nice stuff. If a man carries this about him together with the heart of a mole. This is sick people. Very disgusting. Page 32, to make chickens lay many eggs. Take the dung of rabbits, pound it to powder, mix it with bran, wet the mixture till it forms lumps, and feed your chickens with it. And they will keep on laying a great many eggs. Words to be spoken while making divinatory wands. Divining rod, do thou keep that power which God gave unto thee at the very first hour. Oh, so you have a divining rod, divination, and God gives it. Really? Let me just show you a little scripture here quick. We have, let me get this stupid book out of the way. Deuteronomy chapter 18, beginning in verse 9. When thou art come into the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of those nations. There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or that useth divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch, or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination of the Lord, and because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee. So you read in the Old Testament all these different times when the Lord is just saying, go on in there and just kill these people, just slaughter them right and left. Why? Because they're practicing this kind of a thing. Written by a Roman Catholic priest. But Roman Catholicism is the one true church. And don't give me this, well, that was Vatican after Vatican II. We're talking the 13th century here. A canonized saint in the pre-Vatican II Catholic Church, before the Jesuits even showed up. This is in the glory days of Catholicism. One of the Catholic Church's greatest scholars that ever lived wrote a book telling you to sacrifice animals and things. And he even admitted it. Homan admitted to getting stuff from Albertus Magnus's writings. Page 33. To remove pain and heal up wounds with three switches, with this switch and Christ's dear blood, I banish your pain and do you good. Three crosses. Again, you're going to see that thing throughout this book. This thing of Christ's blood, the blood of Christ, the blood of Christ. Where do you think the Baptists got this thing of, I plead the blood upon whatever. I had to plead the blood of Jesus. Where'd you get that from? It ain't in Scripture. Where'd you get it? Right there. You got it from Roman Catholicism. Now, I had a lot of friends in the Baptist system. I myself was in the Baptist system for a while, and you think, man, it's a good system and stuff like this. But I'll tell you what, the more I study, the more I realize how wicked that thing is. You need to come out of it. You need to get as far away from it as you can. Page 35. How to cause male or female thieves to stand still without being able to move backward or forward. O Peter, borrow the power from God. What I shall bind with the bands of a Christian hand shall be bound. All male and female thieves, be they great or small, young or old, shall be spellbound by the power of God. Spellbound by God's power. You see it, though? You see their little Roman Catholic thing about Peter, the Catholic Church says, well, the church is built on Peter, and he has the power to bind and loose and all this other stuff. Crazy. This thing was definitely written by Magnus. Page 36. Cure for the epilepsy. Look at this one. Take a turtle dove, cut its throat, and let the person afflicted with epilepsy drink the blood. Drink the blood. Turn to the book of Acts, chapter 15. That ye abstain from meats offered idols, and from blood, and from things strangled, and from fornication, from which if ye keep yourselves, ye shall do well. Fare ye well. Isn't that interesting? Over here in verse 20. But that ye write unto them that they abstain from pollutions of idols, and from fornication, and from things strangled, and from blood. Very interesting. And who was one of the speakers? Peter rose up and said unto them. So do you realize what you read there? Peter. You know Peter? The founder of the Catholic Church, according to Catholicism. He's right there in the council in Acts chapter 15, and he says, don't drink any blood. And yet this Catholic scholar comes out and says, oh no, actually drink the blood. If you have epilepsy, just get a dove, cut its throat, and drink the blood. You're dealing with Satanists. Canonized. Eulogized. Doctor of the law, or doctor of the Catholic Church. Satanist. Sickening. A good remedy for those who cannot keep their water. This is the next page, right? There's that one, this one here. Burn a hog's bladder to powder and take it inwardly. Yes, right. Next page. A good way to cause children to cut their teeth without pain. Boil the brain of a rabbit and rub the gums of the children with it, and their teeth will grow without pain to them. You see, part of the way this thing works, let me just say this, is the thing of they call it a placebo effect. Okay, you're given sugar, and you don't just give the person a sugar pill. You give it, and you do this big promotion. You hypnotize them, essentially. You say, now this, I can only give you one of these pills because it is so extremely strong. Maybe I should cut it in half. Well, no, you know what? You're in a lot of pain. I want you to have it gone very quickly, so I'm going to give you this pill, and it's going to knock that headache out quickly. If you start to feel a little bit dizzy, just sit down because it's really strong. Anti-pain, pill. And the person, you get them all under the mind control of, this is a really powerful thing, and it's just sugar is all it is. They do this all the time. It's part of the whole trials and stuff that they do for any kind of drug that comes out. They'll do tests with placebos. Sometimes, not all the time, but they'll do this thing. See, you can get into somebody's head and make them think that they're being cured. And that's what a lot of this stuff is. You do this really dark, twisted type of stuff, and you go, well, this has to work, you know. And if it doesn't work, you say, I must have said the spell wrong. I'll have to try that again. And for the times that it actually does work, it's because the devils that you've been possessed with by messing with this witchcraft, those devils are making things happen in your body. See, you don't have any protection from devils if you're lost. You're saved? Yeah. Devils can't mess with you unless the Lord gives them permission, and that, you know, isn't going to happen if you're walking right with the Lord and if you have your home cleansed of evil things, which I'm going to be doing as soon as I'm done with this study. But bad stuff. But let's continue. Page 40. Commencing on the last Friday of the last quarter of the moon. So we're dealing with astrology here too. Page 41. For the scurvy and sore throat, speak the following, and it will certainly help you. Job went through the land, holding his staff close in the hand, when God the Lord did meet him, and said to him, Job, what art thou grieved at? Job said, O God, why should I not be sad? My throat and my mouth are rotting away. Then said the Lord to Job, in yonder valley there is a well which will cure thee, and then you insert your name there, and thy mouth and thy throat, in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. This must be spoken 3 times in the morning and 3 times in the evening. And where it reads, which will cure, you must blow 3 times in the child's mouth. Okay. And I have here, not in the Bible. This is nowhere in the Bible. It says, God said there, you know, where's it here? Said to him, God the Lord did meet him and said to him. So, you know, again, typical Roman Catholic. They can rewrite the Bible whenever they feel like it. You know, scripture, there's sacred scripture, but then we also have divine tradition. And when the two come together, you get rid of, you know, sacred scripture and elevate divine tradition. They're Satanists. They add to and subtract from the Word of God anytime that they feel like it. And then try to blame God for it. Page 43. On the first Friday in the decreasing moon, and immediately after hanging it around the neck, the Lord's Prayer and the Articles of Faith must be repeated. Catholicism, folks. And you say, well, but, you know, need to make another little mention here. You say, well, wouldn't some Bible-believing Christian have pointed this out? There weren't many Bible-believing Christians back in those years. Okay, there were some, the Waldensians and you know, the Huguenots and some of the different groups that were out away from the big cities and things. Just trying to survive from the Vatican, you know, crusaders and whatnot that were going around killing, you know, heretics. But most of the people did not have the Bible. So the Catholics could get away with all this witchcraft just being practiced openly. You know? And as more people put away their King James Bibles and go back to Alexandrian versions, which come from the Vatican, or no Bible at all, the Vatican's bringing out witchcraft more and more. Right now, as I speak, the Pope has had 2 bodies of Catholic saints, Padre Pio and I forget the other guy, brought to the Vatican. And they're parading these dead bodies around and stuff. You know, Catholic saints, the dead corpse laying there. I mean, show me this in Scripture. See? They're Satanists. They're in the sacrifice, ritual sacrifice. I mean, that's what the system of Catholicism is. The Eucharist. It is a ritual, I'll say the word, human sacrifice. They're sacrificing Jesus every day, over and over and over and over. You have to eat his flesh and drink his blood. Completely a violation of Scripture. Acts chapter 15, Peter saying, don't eat blood. Oh no, this is it's wine, but it's actual blood. Under the appearance of wine. And the wafer there, the round wafer, the sun god there, it's, you know, wheat. It's a wheat wafer, but it's actually flesh. Well, then you're in violation of Scripture. Congratulations, you bunch of Satanists. Page 45. And they'd put people to death for saying these sorts of things. That's why I'm worked up. Our dear Lord Jesus Christ and our dearest Virgin and her dear little babe with her 7 rings and her true things. Huh? Her 7 rings? Chapter and verse on that? That any gun or other arms may not do me any harm, any more harm than the virginity of our Holy Virgin Mary was injured by the favor of her beloved Jesus. Huh? Her virginity was harmed? injured by the favor of her beloved Jesus. After this, say three Lord's prayers, the Ave Maria, and the Articles of Faith. Catholic witchcraft. I don't mess with much stuff in the occult, you know, anymore, but this is one I'm glad I purchased, because this one just shows plainly Roman Catholicism is witchcraft. Written by one of their doctors. Canonized Saint Albert the Great. Yeah. Page 46. As certainly as Mary retained her virginity before all ladies who retained theirs. Perpetual virginity of Mary there. I command unto thee fire to abate thy heat by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Pleading the blood. And a lot of Baptists do that exact thing right now. I plead the blood, you know. There's whole songs. I saw some Hamite church and stuff, and they're like singing, I plead the blood, you know, stuff. Just keep repeating it. You know, it's disgusting. A lot of people repeat it ignorantly, okay? I did a few times early on, you know, I fell for the thing, and actually had a brother say, where's it at in Scripture? And I was like, well, check into it. I checked into it, and it's like, there's nowhere in there where it says, plead the blood of Jesus. Not one verse of Scripture in the King James Bible. I can't speak for the other satanic new versions. They change them all the time. I can't keep up with it. But it's not in Scripture. But it is in this witch's book here, written by a Catholic. Page 47. To prevent conflagration, take a black chicken in the morning or evening, cut its head off, and throw it upon the ground. Cut its stomach out, yet leave it all together. Then try to get a piece of a shirt which was worn by a chaste virgin during her terms, and cut out a piece as large as a common dish from that part which is bloodiest. These two things wrap up together, then try to get an egg which was laid on Monday, Thursday. You recognize that if you're Lutheran or Catholic too. These three things put together in wax, then put them in a pot holding 8 quarts and bury it under the threshold of your house. And then it talks about with the aid of God, you'll never have a fire there. Conflagration is their way of, 1800s way of saying fire, like a house fire. See, this is why you see this dual personality with the Amish, you know. Out in public, it's holy, you know, and everything else. They're whited sepulchers, but inwardly they're full of dead men's bones. You get around them in private, and they're very, very wicked, very evil people. And you'll see an anger coming out of them that'll scare you. Very, very bad people. And again, somebody's going to say, they're not all that way. But the ones that are quote-unquote decent people cover up for the ones that are bad. I know. Right here in Maine, down south of us, the Smyrna Commune, I'll call it that. The Smyrna Commune. I knew an Amishman down there, and he was like, yeah, there's some, you know, child molestation going on, and there's some of this and that and stuff, and we're just kind of, we pray for him and try to talk to him and stuff. So you can't go to the law. You can't report things. You just kind of softly cover it up because, you know, we all make these mistakes and things, and it's disgusting. And it's interesting, too, how the secular law a lot of times will turn their head. You start reporting things about the Amish, and it's just kind of like, I didn't see anything. Yeah, because they're monastic Catholics, that's why. Page 48. How to fasten or spellbind anything. You say Christ's cross and Christ's crown, Christ Jesus colored blood. Fasten or spellbind. Again, you use the blood. 3 crosses, then say the Lord's Prayer 3 times. Catholic. Page 49. The holy rosy blood of our dear Lord Jesus Christ may rule it. Again, the blood. How to relieve persons or animals after being bewitched. Blood, blood, God in the body of Mary shall bless thee. Catholic. Roman Catholic thing here. And then spake Jesus. And I read this already before in the other thing there. You can see it again. There's no scripture saying this. So you just make up your own scripture, apparently. Against dangers and mishaps in the house. Saint Matthias, Saint Marcus, Saint Lucas, Saint Johannes. Yeah. Call upon the saints. You know, they call them the 4 evangelists. Against evil spirits and all manner of witchcraft, Sanctus Spiritus, the cross, again. I forget what the INRI stands for, INRI. But these lines must be written on three pieces of white paper, then take the milk of the sick cow and three pieces of paper, put them in a pot, and scrape a little of the skull of a criminal, close it well, and put it over a hot fire, and the witch will have to die. Where are you getting the skull of a criminal? Well, see, it all works out kind of nice because you, well, while you're there at the graveyard and you've dug up the grave, you know, you can get the three nails out of the coffin for your one spell, and then you can take the skull out, you know, the criminal, and then you got that for other ritual magic purposes. Sure. Good Christian fun here, you know. Faith healing. This is faith healing. It's completely scriptural. They were doing this in the book of Acts. Page 52. Then spake our dear lady to Saint Peter. Our dear lady said, and talks about the guardianship of Saint Daniel. That's interesting. This I command thee by the Holy Virgin Mary, the Mother of God. Wow. Isn't that nice? Page 53. With the blood of Jesus Christ, with his five holy wounds, thy barrel, thy gun, and thy pistol are bound. Saber, sword, and knife are enchanted and bound. Thought we read something about charmers and enchanters in the Bible. But why should we listen to the Bible? You know, the Catholic Church is higher authority than sacred scripture, so let's just listen to those witches. Right. Page 54. The third nail I shall drive into thy foot, O thief. O thief, I bind thee and compel thee by the three holy nails which were driven through the hands and feet of Jesus Christ. The three nails, however, must be greased with the grease from an executed criminal or other sinful person. Again, you're having to take part of a body of an executed criminal and boil down the fat of that body so that you can use it for ritual magic. And this is not joking. This is not like, oh, they're just joking. This is serious. And, you know, too, if you want to take it back to the time of the writing of this thing with Albertus Magnus, they would have been executing a lot of, you know, Christians that they would call heretics, you know, so they would consider them criminals. So they're basically taking, more than likely, taking parts of the bodies of Christians and using it for ritual magic. Interesting, because Oliver Cromwell, when they had, the members of Parliament had risen up against the royalist system with King Charles I. King Charles I was King James's son. He married a Catholic, very, very wicked man, and he was doing all kinds of evil things there in England, and they had the English Civil War. Cromwell eventually got put in as Lord Protector of England. When he died, Oliver Cromwell was a great man. When he died, King Charles II came back to England shortly thereafter. I think Cromwell's son Richard, I think, took over for a little while. But when Richard was deposed, King Charles II takes over again as the King of England. And when they came back, they dug up Oliver Cromwell's body. And they beheaded his dead corpse, and they were like doing all kinds of weird stuff. Do a little bit of research. King Charles II, they were practicing bone magic and things like this, grinding up parts of dead bodies and using them for ritual purposes. See, he was a trained Catholic. His mommy was a Catholic. King Charles I, his wife, was a Roman Catholic. Hardcore militant Catholic. Hated Bible-believing Christians. That's why she hated Cromwell. So she taught her son how to use rituals performed by Roman Catholics to mess with dead bodies. But that's okay, you know, we can just tolerate Catholicism. No, we can't. 54. To win every game one engages in, tie the heart of a bat with a red silken string to the right arm, and you will win every game at cards you play. Again, just showing you there, that's what was in the pamphlet that we read earlier. Next page. If the bleeding will not stop, or if a vein has been cut, then lay the following on it, and it will stop that hour. Yet if anyone does not believe this, Look at this. Let him write the letters upon a knife and stab an irrational animal, and he will not be able to draw blood. Okay. Again. I don't know if this is going to work. Okay, well then write these letters, you know, on a knife and just go out and see one of your farm animals that's kind of irrational. It's kind of misbehaves a lot and stuff. And just go over and start stabbing the thing, you know, and you say, hey, look at that. Oh, there is blood coming out. Oh, that didn't work right. I'll try it again. Write some more letters on it. I'll try stabbing the thing again. It's instructions in their book. Okay? I'm not making this stuff up. It's instructions in this satanic book that's popular among the Amish. Next page, page 57. Upon the holy assistance of God and my gun, I rely very truly. I thought these people were pacifists. And there's a whole other thing there too, by the way. You know, I've heard some rumors on this. I don't have the documentation to prove this, but the rumors are that there's actually members of military special ops types of people, Delta Force and things like this, you know, highly ranking mind controlled soldiers, essentially, that they hide among the Amish and things. It's kind of weird stuff. I know there was a guy up here, I don't know, his channel was Main Prepper, was what his thing was, and he was talking about he was going to join the Amish for a while. And he was like in psychological warfare operations in the military. Weird. Down a little bit farther on the page here it says, for we have tasted the rosy blood of Jesus. See the Catholic thing? Your rifles and guns will be stopped up with the holy blood of Jesus. All right, just tell you a little, another story here. Back when I was down in Lancaster County before I knew my wife, I was in ministry with a brother named Jesse Dolesky. And he was a good friend of mine and everything. And we did a lot of, went out, did the door-to-door thing and, you know, had a lot of good times going out, you know, witnessing and stuff to people. And the one time I wasn't with him, and when him and another brother were out doing some ministry type of stuff, and he ran into this cult, the satanic cult down there called Charity Ministries. And Charity Ministries was created by a Baptist from Jack Hiles College there, Denny Keniston, the guy's name was. Denny Keniston and an Amishman came together and created Charity Ministries. And so a lot of Amish were leaving the Amish system, coming to Charity Ministries, because then they can drive vehicles and have electricity, but they still hold on to a lot of their same kooky, nutty, you know, occult beliefs. And Jesse was an ex-Marine. He was a sergeant in the Marine Corps. And he got into this talk the one time with some Charity Ministries wing nut. And he said about, you know, you're a pacifist and all this stuff. And of course, Charity Ministries, they were into pacifism. You know, we don't fight and all this stuff. And I did a whole study on that, refuting Denny Keniston's ridiculous nonsense teachings on pacifism. But this guy said to Brother Jesse, Jesse said to him, what would happen if some guy came and pointed a gun at you and was going to kill you and your wife and children? And you know what the guy said? He said, I would pray and God would stop the bullets. And we just kind of laughed about it. We were like, you know, I would rebuke the bullets and it would stop them. And I joked about it in my study years ago, and I said, well, I guess, you know, you'd have a real problem if it was a fully automatic gun, because you got to do a lot of rebuking really quickly. And not realizing that what this Charity Ministries guy was saying is, and we're going to show you this as I continue, he's actually talking about this book. Through occult powers, they teach that you can stop bullets. I'm going to show it to you. You just saw a little bit right there. So, unbeknownst to us, this guy from Charity Ministries, one of the attendees of Charity Ministries, was actually a practicing witch, hiding under the banner of, I'm a pacifist, ex-Amish Charity Ministries person. I follow Christ. Mm-hmm. And again, what they mean when they say, I follow Christ, what a Catholic says, I follow Christ, that means that they're trying to imitate Jesus Christ. They're not coming to the cross and falling down and saying, I'm a sinner. I have nothing to offer you. They come to the cross and they say, I bet you I could do better than that. I want to have experience. I want to have feeling. I want to get in communion with God through my own self-righteousness. Yeah. That's what they do. But let's continue here. Page 58, a charm against firearms. Here we'll see it. I, and you give your name there, conjure ye guns, swords, and knives, as well as all other kinds of arms. I conjure ye by Saint Stephen, look at this, who was stoned by the Virgin. Okay, I've been through Acts chapter 7 quite a few times. I didn't see Mary stoning Stephen. You know, that's why I put a question mark. I'm just kind of like, he's stoned by the Virgin. Okay. Continuing. Protection against all kinds of weapons. Keep thou thy fire like the Virgin Mary, who kept her fire both before and after her birth. I don't think I really want to know what her fire is a reference to there. Furthermore, do thou guard the three holy drops of blood which Christ sweated on the Mount of Olives. Chapter and verse on that, there weren't three drops of blood. That's whatever, there were drops of blood, but it doesn't say three. Jesus, do thou not suffer me to be killed, much less to be damned without having received the Lord's Supper. So you don't want to die without taking Holy Mass, because Mass is where your sins are forgiven. Catholic. Page 59. A charm against shooting, cutting, or thrusting. Those five holy red wounds, O Lord Jesus Christ, may they guard me against all firearms, be they secret or public, that they cannot injure me or do me any harm whatever in the name of, and then you give the three crosses. May Jesus Christ, with his guardianship and protection, shield me, your name, always from daily commission of sins. Okay, so you're not going to commit sins. You're living a sinlessly perfect life there. Worldly injuries and injustice. You're shielded from this as a Christian? I don't think so. From contempt, from pestilence and other diseases, from fear, torture, and great suffering. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. You're supposed to suffer for Jesus. From all evil intentions and from false tongues and old clatter brains. Oh, okay. And that no kind of firearms can inflict any injury to my body, do thou take care of me. May the dear Virgin Mary, down there again, to charm guns and other arms. You're charming them. But it's Christian. I mean, yes, it's condemned in Deuteronomy chapter 18 and elsewhere throughout the Bible. But see, we just throw out the parts of the Bible that we don't want. Sure. Not if you're a Bible-believing Christian, you don't. The blessing which the priest spoke over the tender, joyful corpse of our Lord Jesus Christ be with me, the constancy of the Holy Mary and all the saints of God. Again, spoke over the tender, joyful corpse of our Lord Jesus Christ. What are they talking about there? And when was there ever a Catholic priest speaking anything over the actual body of Jesus in the Bible? There wasn't any. So what are they talking about? The Eucharist. The consecrated host. What they're talking about. Stinking pagan, satanic, Roman Catholic book. Spell book. Really looking forward to getting this study done so I can burn this stinking thing. But down further on the page, may the eternal Godhead also guard me through the bitter sufferings of Jesus Christ, his holy rosy blood shed on the cross, assist me there. Then you say Jesus, Jesus, Jesus is what the J's there, just shorten, you know, for Jesus. But again, you see they're pleading the blood essentially is what's going on there. Before me, all guns or other weapons shall be of no use or power. Firearms, hold your fire in the almighty hand of God. Thus all firearms shall be charmed. May the eternal God protect me by the rosy blood. Written hundreds of years before any Baptist was saying it. Our dear Lady Mary upon a very high mountain. This is when Jesus was being crucified, talking about up here. He's being crucified. She's up there on top of a very high mountain, looked down and all the stuff, and she sees him being crucified. Okay, chapter and verse on that one, please. Where's this at? I guess maybe you could say she was up in the high places, you know? Never. Page 62. Again, I conjure thee. A very effective charm. I, your name, conjure thee. A very safe and reliable charm. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with me. O shot, stand still. In the name of the mighty prophets, Agtion and Elias. Elias there. Okay, scripture on that, please. And do not kill me. Oh, Shot, stop short. I conjure you by heaven and earth and by the last judgment that you do no harm unto me, a child of God. You have to say that pretty quickly to stop being shot. Okay. Here we have page 63. A well-tried charm. Three holy drops of blood. Three holy drops of blood, our dear lady. Another well-tried charm against firearms. And this is Christian faith healing. Yeah. Sure it is. Page 64. So surely as the mother of God shall not bring forth another son. So she's perpetual virgin, you know, virginity. Mary had other children, by the way, too. They're listed in the Bible. A charm to gain advantage of a man of superior strength. Another charm. That the holy corpse of God may bless me against all evil things, words, and works. The Eucharist, in other words. The rosy blood protect me from all my enemies and from everything which might be injurious to my body or soul or my worldly goods. Now, that's pleading the blood. That is exactly what it is. Going back to the 1200s. Albertus Magnus, doctor of the church. Roman Catholic monk. Professor to Thomas Aquinas. Page 67. Under the bush and the stone, you must place the skull of a malefactor. Another one of the spells here. How are you going to get it? Kind of sick. The signs of the zodiac must be observed by the course of the moon, and they are daily given in the common almanacs. So again, you have astrology. The following remedy for epilepsy was published in Lancaster, PA papers in the year 1828. Okay. Don't know if there's anything else here I'm going to show. I think we're pretty much done. But just, it's a sick, disgusting book, I'll tell you what. And I've had this thing outside in my outdoors in the shed that I built, you know, a couple years back. Because I didn't want this thing in here, you know. But I just, you know, this type of thing, it's like, okay, Lord, I'm going to get this done as quick as I can. I've been working on this study very hard. And I'm just like, you know what? I need to get this done. I'm going to burn this thing. Here we go. One last time. Page 80. I pray in the name of Christ's blood. So, all throughout the thing, pleading the blood, pleading the blood, pleading the blood. You know. It's right there. So, just really, really, really disturbing, very disgusting. There's a whole bunch more stuff I could show on this, and I'll probably be bringing out other things on this subject, but I just wanted to show this wicked book here. I'm going to enjoy immensely burning this thing. It was a very expensive, very valuable, rare book. You know, I mean, it's just so valuable and rare. I couldn't stand to think of anything bad happening to such an important part of history. I mean, I try to take such good care of the thing, you know. I mean, it's such a wonderful thing to have it in my collection. I'm so honored, you know. Truly, truly disgusting. How many people have been deceived by Roman Catholicism? Roman Catholicism. Let me get a piece of the spell book off my Bible. Roman Catholicism is the world's most satanic cult. They are capable of insane cruelty. When you read Fox's Book of Martyrs, it is so horrible, so terrible. And they'll vehemently deny it. And you see this thing, I see this all the time in the comments, and these Catholics, you haven't studied church history, you know, you just studied from the Protestant side. Yeah, because they're telling the truth. You know, when a Catholic says you should study church history, what they're saying is their own propaganda books put out by their own church that cover up their dastardly deeds, their murderous crimes, that's studying church history. It's absolutely disgusting what these people do. So I'm going to close this video. Thank you very much for watching. Don't be deceived by this thing. I'm actually not going to do a study now on the thing of pleading the blood. It was in this one. Whatever. Because I ripped it up now. So I can't wait to go burn this thing. So I'll see in just a little bit here. We're going to go out. We're going to burn this thing. The proper way to dispose of a satanic book like this. Thank you for watching. All right. The time has come to burn these. I got them in a plastic bag there. But this is all the stuff. This is the way you handle occult books. Don't sell them on eBay or try to give them away or just give them to Goodwill or something. Into the fire. As the smoke blows right at me. Burn, burn, burn. And as I've said in other studies, we burn this type of stuff, but we'll never burn the people that are involved in it. We're not Catholic. We don't burn people at the stake. We pray for people. We show people the wickedness of witchcraft and things and Satanism so that you can get out of it. Okay? You don't have to mess around with this stuff. It's wickedness. It will land you in the lake of fire for all of eternity. So if you have this, if you've fallen for this long-lost friend stuff, it's not Christian. It's not somehow okay by God or whatever else. It's an abomination. You need to burn it.